Are you in a lot of pain? All the time? I know I am. Or was. Till I started doing this. This is what to do with cannabis roots. It's a highly effective painkiller. And once you get it in contact with your body, within minutes, the pain is gone. So what we're going to do is, we separated, you know, the big stuff and the medium stuff and then all the little fine root ball. These are hydroponic. They're brown because they're stained from the nutrients. I use advanced nutrients. The brown staining on them is from the organics that's in those advanced nutrients. So I cut this plant last night and separated the roots just now. And now I'm going to stick it in the freezer for a minute. And when I come back, we'll be able to see just exactly what's going on here and how we're going to get you pain-free off of basically some waste from your little home grow. This is probably enough to keep one person pain-free for close to a year. Cannabis roots are tied to people living over 100 years when they drink a tiny amount of it every day. But what I'm after is the pain-killing properties for the arthritis and nerve pain, muscle spasms, and things like that. It's also been reported to be highly effective for fibromyalgia and major issues that don't have any medical relief. So, here goes, y'all. This stuff's going in the freezer, and we'll be back in a little while to continue the process. Alright, so we didn't get a whole bunch of it grinded up. It really needs to be dried and stuff. I froze it and threw some in the blender, and it got pretty fine. It's broke up real good. Still frozen and kind of wet, but well, there it is. See, we used the blender. I'm gonna rinse that out. That right there will probably save your whole life. Make you live a million years. It don't matter. So yeah, I'm going to cover the roots with water. And I'm going to cook it down a couple times. Keep adding more water to it. Alright. Yeah, let it boil. It's already good. My hands are bad, man. You can probably see some swelling in my wrist and shit right there, man. It's crazy. Same thing happens to my neck. Anyway, we're gonna let that cook for a minute. Roll that boil. Get it going good. Don't be scared of it. Roll the shit out of it. Alright. So we're gonna cook this down. And be back. I'm gonna put water in it about 2-3 times. Cook it down, put some more water in it, you know, don't let it go dry, just cook it for a minute, alright? Be back. Okay, it started boiling good. See them bubbles? That's fat inside them roots. It's also medicine. Got some coconut oil. We're going to put some of that in there, enough to make a nice layer over the top. That way we can separate it later. All right. It's been boiling for a while. Quite a few hours. Probably put about a gallon of water through it. So, let's see if we soaked up all the fat. Shouldn't be any bunch of bubbles and shit on top. Oh, did good. So there it is. Now we're about to strain it. Okay, so it's about done boiling. See what I did there? Just stack your coffee filters in there. Put them around the edges first, and then put your one in the middle, and then get them all wet, and they'll stick together like one big filter. So let me get this shit here. And dump it on in. Okay, so we're just gonna store this in the blender and continue it until it's all done. It's better to do while it's hot. So there's that. Talk to you in a little bit. A beautiful sight. We're about to put this in the freezer. You can see the oil starting to separate from the water. Nice, nice. All right. As soon as it comes out the freezer, we can separate that oil and the water is usable. I used a mix of all of it and rubbed it on my hands. They were dying. See, I got braces on both of them. They were fucking dying. And I'm good. I had a real bad headache from my neck. Rubbed some across my neck and shoulders. Done with it. Took about 5 minutes. All right. That's it. That's how you do it. Go save some people, y'all. Have a good one.